Hello all, welcome to our learning series again. Today we are going to discuss about a small yet interesting personality test for children. This is very simple test and can be used by any professional working with children, including teachers. Teachers go through a paper during their training on trial psychology. Yet many other times they remain confused about what's wrong with the child. So, if you are a teacher, this session is going to be very interesting for you. If school is the second home to a child, teachers are their second parent. Now, this is a projective test. Well, we will learn about this term in detail too. We will learn in this video only what this test does and what are the flags that determine whether we must consult the school psychologist for further help. Childhood is very different from adulthood. Lack of expression, vocabulary, maturity, and ideas makes it very difficult to understand a child. It is often observed that teachers are the first few people who find out different, not normal or regular behaviors, pattern or understanding or learning need in a child. With experience, they are able to pick out children who need attention. Very regular incidents are when the child runs to the board for reading or when he or she remains aloof or talks by himself or is extremely inobedient, aggressive, etc. When is unable to read or write or making mistakes that requires attention. During essay writing, many times teachers were taken aback by reading essay on family, parents, friends, etc. Or during a drawing where they understood that the child's issue need to be resolved beyond a class. What should you do when you understand your child need attention? Should you give personal advice or no, you must reach your senior principal or school psychologist with whatever made you feel that child's need help. This is very, very important. Though we have learned child psychology, we are not authorized for assessment and conclusion. Also, referring or discussing with parents without proper counseling knowledge should not be done. Okay guys, so let's get started. Today we are going to learn an interesting personality test. You can try with your children. It's easy and really enjoyable. Psychology is the science of mind and behavior. Psychology includes the study of conscious and unconscious phenomena, and this is the scientific study that how people behave, think, and feel. Psychologists study everything about the human experience, from the basic workings of the human brain to consciousness, memory, reasoning, language to personality, and mental health. It is comparatively very easy to understand adult human mind, but it is very difficult to understand the child's mind. It is because they lack experience, they lack expression, they lack vocabulary, and they do not actually understand what the border lines between right and wrong. They do not have lot of expressions like adults. So eventually, we have seen in the past lessons how child psychology merged as a major branch in psychology. Child psychology is the study of subconscious and conscious childhood development. Child psychologists observe how a child interacts with their parents, themselves, and the world to understand their mental development. The psychologist has to go into the depth and it involves a lot of time to understand what the child is going through, unlike an adult. Psychological testing is the administration of psychological tests. Psychological tests are administered by trained evaluators. A person's response are evaluated according to carefully prescribed guidelines. Psychological testings, also called psychometrics, the systematic use of tests to quantify psychological behavior, abilities, and problems, and to make predictions about psychological performance. There are many types of tests like intelligence test, personality test, attitude test, achievement test, aptitude test, neuropsychological test, occasional test, direct observation test, behavioral test, clinical test, etc. Today, we are going to see personality test. A personality test is a tool used to assess human personality. Personality testing and assessment refer to techniques designed to measure the characteristics patterns of traits that people exhibit across various situations. Personality is something that we informally assess and describe every day. A personality test is a method of assessing human personality constructs. The Draw a Person test is a psychological projective personality or cognitive test used to evaluate children and adolescents for a variety of purposes. This test used to measure nonverbal intelligence or to screen for emotional or behavior disorder. The Draw a Person test is a projective drawing task that is often utilized in psychological assessment of children. Although there are a number of variations, an individual is typically asked to draw a picture of a person. Limitation of DAP test. Goodenough Harris Draw a Person test has been criticized by some for being outdated, and the scoring instruction have been found to elaborate and imprecise. The historical survey in Goodenough measurement of intelligence by drawing reviews this area since 1885 and indicates a continued interest of investigators in many parts of the world in the drawings of children. A recurrent theme suggested in most of the published observations was that some characteristics of the drawings were subject to a developmental process and showed significant maturation changes. More recently, this general feeling has grown to include personality factors as a major aspect of drawing behavior, to the point where current emphasis has now shifted from the formal accepts of scoring necessary in the evaluation of intelligence to the more dynamic aspects of drawing behavior, such as subjective interpretation of this behavior as it pertains to projective techniques. Now, let's see how this test is conducted.
Draw a Person test. This test can be applied on a 4-year-old child to 89-year-old game-like test. It would be fun for the children, and you will also get to know about the child better. Now that we have understood what a projective test is all about, and also about Draw a Person test is, we can start the test. In this test, we have to make the child sit comfortably and provide him with a paper and a pencil. If you are a psychology student, just keep your manual and scorecards ready. But it should be away from the child. We will use it after the activity. So let's start the test. So now, let's see what are the requirements or the materials needed for the test. Blank sheet, pencil, and eraser. One thing I would like to tell about the eraser is that we have surely kept the eraser in our required material, but will not provide it to the child till the child asks for it. We have Ritvik with us, who is a school student and is going to give us a demo on how to conduct a DAP test. Hello Ritvik.
Hi.
Okay. Now, first, we will provide the blank sheet to the child. We will provide it in a portrait size, and as said earlier, we will only provide the pencil and not the eraser. Ritvik, you will have to draw a full picture of yourself from top till your feet. As you see yourself in the mirror, you should draw it in that way. Start drawing, Ritvik. Thank you. In this test, we do not have any time limitations. We should give full time to the client, how much ever they want. Maximum, within 15 to 30 minutes, a person finishes the drawing. So there is actually no need to keep any time limitation. We have to keep one more thing in mind, that in the whole room, there is no picture or poster of any figure. We should see that the client draws on its own and there should not be any correction or interpretation. So now we have seen as Ritwik has finished his drawing. I want some details from you, Ritwik. What is your date of birth?
11/11/2011.
Thank you so much, Ritwik. Now you can go. Thank you so much for the help.
Thank you.
Now let us see some interesting cases and works by experts. Child health, mental health caregivers, works using various tools while working with children. Art therapy is one among them. Look at all these pictures carefully and understand what the child tries to convey. These pictures are also available on the net.